Man, my face looks fat as hell. I just sold that hole, man. Fuck, man. What am I supposed to do? My face looks fat as fuck. Well, that's my face. My face is my face. So, I'm sort of with you. Well, I still record videos despite being nervous while doing them. Because I'm trying proactively to get used to recording myself. And honestly, it's kind of like shameful looking back and my face is kind of fatty, I got fat in my face, etc, etc. But like, the fuck, what can I do about that other than lose weight? And that will take some time. And if anything, my journey losing weight will be inspiring. I did record my face before as well. I was afraid to post those videos because I was so fucking fat. And I've lost a lot of weight since then. I lost a total of 18 kilograms. At my heaviest, I was 18 kilograms. Now I am 70 at my lowest. So I lost 18 kilograms in total, almost 20 kg, which is like 50 pounds. I lost 50 pounds. I'm like, how much is that? 60 pounds. How much is 20 kilograms to pounds? 44 pounds. I lost 44 pounds in total, roughly. And I still like, even then I lost a bunch of weight, I still look fat in my face a bit, and I still want to record myself for videos. Despite being nervous, I'm like, fucking nervous when recording these videos, because I think it's like such a... It invokes so much growth, for not only for the channel, but for myself. I'm getting used to this shit. If I'm used to it, I think that I will make more progress and grow the channel more and be satisfied thereafter. I'm at a weird point where I just need to start. I'm just showing you guys that I just need to start. You need to just start recording videos. It doesn't matter if anyone comes at you and fucking gives you the hate comment. Hey, your video is stupid. You're not saying anything. What you're saying isn't new. What you're saying, nothing of course I'm saying is new. Nothing is new anymore. Perhaps my take seems fresh and new, but for the most part, nothing is new anymore. Damn, with that feminine voice. I still record videos. My friend asked me, so why do you record videos despite being nervous while doing them? Despite like, kind of not wanting to do them? Because that's the whole point of discipline. Because that's the whole point. Everyone wants to be a YouTuber, but when it starts comes down to recording themselves for videos or editing, no one wants to do that shit. Why? Because they're lazy. Because they haven't started there because they're nervous. They find some artificial excuse that doesn't benefit them in any way. Why? I'm probably going to get 600 videos. I got a list of video ideas with fresh in my mind. Honestly, recording videos after a while gets quite therapeutic to me. And I retain a lot of hope. Like, people give me the thing. Oh, I don't believe you lose weight in like, I don't know, 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, and you lose all that face fat. I probably will, but not now, because I'm dedicating the next 4 years of my life to the bulk, but to grow taller. That's a science experiment I'm gonna do for you guys for a YouTube video. How to grow taller? No bullshit guide. Proven steps. Proof. And people are still gonna come out with the genetics and this is that. My father is 5 foot. I'm already 5'7". I've defined my genes by 7 inches. My mom is also 5 foot. I'm pretty sure she's 4'11" on the dot. They're very short people. And I've defined it by 7 inches. And of course, that isn't uncommon, but 7 inches is 7 inches. And I want to continue to define that. No matter what you say. And I'm going to reach my 5'10", 5'11" goal. And I'm going to laugh in your face when I'm done with that shit. Oi. Why are you looking at me like that? Oi. When you feel so puffy. I love you. Body twitches off. Weird ass cat. And honestly, recording videos and putting my thing out there, it kind of soothes me a bit. It's quite therapeutic to record videos and just speak my emotions. It feels like a little bit of a weight that's being pulled off my chest. I'm gonna have to meditate though in a minute. That's why I record videos. Despite being nervous while doing it. I think everyone should. Everyone should. The introvert should, the extrovert should, the kind of middle 50-50 should. I think I'm quite 50-50 now. I used to be 80-20 extrovert to introvert. Now I'm literally 50-50 introvert to extrovert. Sometimes, I never felt this way. I always used to talk to people, no matter how menial or small talk it was. I usually dislike small talk, but then again, I don't really have small talk. I think I shift the small talk into meaningful talk, right? From like, What the fuck is that door creasing for, man? Some ghosts in my house, bro. Fuck out of here. Fuck out of here, man. Fuck out of here. I think after a while, I get back to my extrovert self when I get back in public. Nervous for my little traineeship session coming up. It's literally an hour. I have an hour of travel. It took me 20 minutes to travel. I want to be there 40 minutes early. So I might just record another video and leave 11:20 or 11:30 and come there directly on time. So I'm just get there on time, do the session, ask questions. I don't even know what to ask. What options do I have now? And what can I do now? And what do you want me to do? Is there anything I can do? Et cetera. Be nice. Be cordial. Be like that for an hour. Be a good boy for an hour. Fuck off for the rest of the day. Be happy. Do my step on the magic bag, bro.